ideal that we are not operating in the unity of the spirit, unity of the faith. We're operating in division, and is that by itself, you know, and of course we're perceived as a religious system, a lower calling of mindset will develop amongst Christians these days. And unfortunately, how low can a Christian go is really the problem that Christians are not aware of, as much as they need to understand that what the scripture said, that, you know, I keep saying 2 Timothy 4 talks about men will not endure sound doctrine, the sound doctrine that is given unto the word of God. People are not going to be about teaching and preaching that sound doctrine, but they shall heap themselves the teachers of itchy ears, you know what I'm saying, believing fables and not the truth. Is, you know, shout out to my friend Sinclair. You know, I love what he was talking about concerning the church hurt. And, you know, I was listening to him and listening to what he's saying, seeing what people's response. And it's like, and it's crazy how many Christians deem the ideal of Christianity in church, you know, that, you know, these days, and say, well, this is, you know, Christianity and this is church. And it's like it's too many people mindset to say, well, and I'm like, can the results speak for itself, really? You know, yeah, the results need to speak for itself. If you want to say that this is an ideal of what the instruction manual speaks of, is supposed to fulfill the product that it is. The healing, miracles, signs and wonders is supposed to carry out. But let me talk about what I'm saying concerning the lower, you know, because here's the thing. I had a conversation with someone and I mentioned about something, and then all of a sudden it was like, you know, I'm not sure about this. And I was like, whoa. And, you know, the ideal aspect of what I learned, you know, how people are perceiving, you know, the ideal of... Now, watch this. Being a Christian is about learning to become like Christ. Everybody thinks being a Christian is more likely, you know, you just start being Jesus, being like Jesus Christ. It's just something pop, well, boom, I'm going to... love my neighbor as love my enemies as I love myself. Blessed. No, this is a learning process. Like Jesus said, take my yoke and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and burdens light. And it's a learning process that is supposed to have you going lower or higher. You know what I'm saying? It's what Christians need to, 2 Corinthians 13, examine their faith, you know what I'm saying? Examine their information that is given to them, and what is the outcome of the information that you are given to you? How much you have a willingness to perform what the Word of God says? Like Jesus said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. But how much willing are you to love an enemy and bless those that curse you? Pray for them that spitefully use you. Have joy in your heart. You know what I'm saying? The joy of the Lord is your strength. And here's the thing. The joy is supposed to be a more powerful strength that I try to tell people. There's a difference between having joy and being happy. See, because being happy is about feeling good of what happens. You know what I'm saying? If something good happens, you happy. That's based upon feeling. But joy of the Lord is regardless of what happens, whether good or bad, you have joy in spite of the situation, knowing that God is going to take care of what needs to be taken care of, and he's going to make right what meant wrong concerning rectifying it. You know what I'm saying? You that joy that, you know, that's supposed to give us strength, that we do not find ourselves, you know, getting worried and, you know, afraid about whatever bad situation, circumstances we have in our life. You know what I'm saying? It's supposed to override it. You know what I'm saying? Override anything that happens in our life. In the natural, the spirit is supposed to be the powerful force. Because that's what Jesus says. The spirit is willing. The spirit is willing to whatever situation occurs, good or bad, it's willing to perform what it is. And the thing is, unfortunately, the church, the world's, because of the, you know, I don't know what to describe it. I guess lukewarm-ish viewpoint. The lukewarm viewpoint of a Christian is quite interesting. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it's like, well, Christians are supposed to believe this. Christians are supposed to believe that. That is contrary to the word of God. You know what I'm saying? Is and you know, people can have their own personal opinions of how things are concerning whatever they want to believe, that is somewhat, that is influenced by this world system. No, not in the kingdom of God. You can't, you know, they need to understand that it is God's kingdom, not our kingdom. It's God's kingdom. For the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. This is not our own righteousness. No, that's Romans 10 and 3, you know what I'm saying? Or 2, I believe. You know, our own righteousness will have us ignorant to the righteousness of God. That will, but, and when we create our own righteousness, now watch this, I do this teaching. What, we're created from the dust of the ground. Where is the dust of the ground at? It's down there. It's down low, down there. You know what I'm saying? The dust of the ground is on the ground, low on the ground. And what happens is, unfortunately, that because of lack of truth is not being taught and more likely revealed to most Christians, that they're willing to settle for whatever the influence of this world system, television and radio and internet, your environment, of what the mundane performance of other Christians, because, you know, it's just it's just too much conforming of ideal viewpoints that this world system is putting out there, and people are not questioning it because they're accepting it based upon what they desire within themselves, or desire to want to believe. And I try to tell people, when you desire to want to believe, that means that you will be deceived. And a lot of people are operating deception and not have a motivation to question beyond the influence that is given to them, to Christians, you know, ministers, like St. Clair was talking about, ministers, that popular ministers, they got all these books out there, and, you know, purchase this book and it's going to help you have a closer relationship with God or something like that. And, you know, they're, you know, selling these books, making a lot of money off of the gospel. You know, is the gospel is supposed to be this money-making machine the way, you know, things supposed to be? Well, Christian says yes, you know. Mass majority of Christians says, yes, it's supposed to be this money-making machine. You know what I'm saying? And everybody accepting, because everybody else accepts it, it's deemed yes, but it's supposed to be. You know, and I was talking to messaging him about, you know, churches. Everybody's deeming that every church building is supposed to have a membership, but the Bible says it's supposed to be one body, many members. You know what I'm saying? How that can make sense to one body, many members, makes sense of someone making buildings and making their own ideal of membership of the churches. Everybody accepting it, but not questioning it. And what they don't realize, that they are looking at a lower calling. You know what I'm saying? And it's a more likely a lower performance. It will be performed. And the nowadays Christianity, our performance is pretty low when it comes to how concerning our influence of the world, of how many people are being influenced by darkness, that a light is not being revealed and manifest in truth concerning truth is not being taught and truth is not being upheld, that people in darkness, like what, light comes, darkness flees. It's not enough darkness fleeing for not enough light of truth to be revealed to people. It's supposed to show forth because of the performance of people that is supposed to be responsible of giving out the word of God, the light, the truth. It's not really giving forth or teaching an ideal of getting people to go a high calling. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's kind of like this that I was thinking, you know, if like every word, like Jesus says, every word is proceeded out of the mouth of God. Now, God is at the heaven, you know, and telling people, calling people to say, hey, love, do what my word of God says. Do what my word of God says. And it's like, you know, people on earth that is in the low ground on the earth saying, hey, do this, and do this. You know, people are calling you and telling you to do something. And it's like people, and it's like God is the highest, you know, calling, and people are the low calling. And it's like people are just like more gravitating to the low calling of influence that is going on in this world than, you know, than the high calling. Because, and you know the reason why? Because it's too high. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, and that's the thing that, you know, I love what the idea of Jesus is saying concerning the Spirit is willing, because the Spirit is about a force that is determined to go high. It's that's what Jesus showed us and endured the cross and endured what he went through. It was determined to go high. You know what I'm saying? It end result of, you know, defeating darkness and going, and Jesus going, ascending up to the heavenly throne, is a determination to go high. You know what I'm saying? It's not trying to stay low. It doesn't, you know, want to fool with low or whatever, the low down, dirty, all kind of influence of this world system that is being influenced right now. It's not settling for that. It's talking about going high. And people are not hearing this high calling, and Jesus showed us the scenario, Matthew 7, you know what I'm saying? Broad is the gate. Many shall go listen to the low calling of men's influence, whether it's religious influence or whether it's the world influence. And this low calling that is, you know, they will heap themselves to teachers of itchy ears, more likely, but not be about the simple truth that St. Clair was trying to say, that the simple truth of the Bible that is written in the Bible, you know what I'm saying? They will not even, you know, consider to be about wanting to find the true performance of the high calling in the Bible, you know what I'm saying? That could supposed to get us going up, you know what I'm saying? It's what people need to be aware of. It's a high calling. It's going to be always a high calling. It will never be a low calling, but it's a low calling to you concerning of what you desire to want to be praised and accepted by people, or be holy and acceptable unto God, is what the struggle of which one you want. You want to be accepted, you know, in this corrupted system, in this earth, or you want the holy, be transformed by the renewing of your mind to be holy and acceptable unto God, is those that understand a high calling and can see what a low calling looks like and understand a high calling of difficulty of getting rid of your flesh, John 3:30, decreasing that he may increase. And you know what I'm saying? Is what the high calling is supposed to get you on that direction, not something that's going to compromise to this crazy, wicked world system of the terrible influence that it got people believing in, that they will not inherit the kingdom of God. All right, that's the message. Hope you got it. God be the Lord. And forever and ever in Jesus' name. Amen.